Hi everyone, today in this video we are going to cover how we design our 3D model staircases in Rhino. I have come up on this page in Arch Daily where I have searched for staircases. So we'll start creating some of them and to give you an idea on how we create these stairs. So let's get started. So first design is something very straightforward. Let me call it layer 1, stair 1. And we create a rectangle and we start with a 0 and give a dimension to the first step. So it will be around, let's say, 1 meter long and 250 mils deep, and the height will be around 150 mils. Okay. It's kind of a residential stair, and then we go into shaded view. Okay, we can put the cap command to close the ends, and then we will just create this as a block and step 1. Okay, and this we'll use an array command, array linear, and we'll give, let's say, 14 steps in a row, and put the bottom point, put the top point, and that's the stair. Okay, now if we see this reference, we can see the timber pieces with a stringer beam below. So what we do is we can create one typical step as a block and we can multiply it across. So let's start with this one. So if I have this, I'll just double click on this and change the depth of this timber by using a scale 1D and give a depth to 100 mils and probably press enter. We get the step like this, and then we can add a stringer beam below, which is, let's say, from the midpoint to the midpoint. Enter. Just make sure that we pick the right point. So this is the start of this and the start. So it is a parallel line, and we'll just extrude it down by 250 mils. We can select the edge of the surface by pressing Ctrl and Shift and then moving it 100 mils up, and then we extrude surface and we'll do both sides and say 50 mils. Okay, this is just the trial one, and then we can just boolean split, or we can add some details over here. So let's say we add a detail which is fixing . And if you want this thing to be more practical, we can even double click on this, add an object into this block, and then boolean difference with this, so you get the notch and you say okay. So we got this staircase. You see a render view. Okay, similarly, if you want the railing to be created, we can do the railing. So we'll just draw, let's say, railing, and draw this line, move it 900 mils or 3 feet up. We click on this circle to extrude and say minus 50 mils. Then we'll need a post 50 by 50. You can just extrude it something more and put it in the center boolean, and then we can copy it on every third step, and then on the other side we can have just the wall. Yeah, so this is one style of staircase. Let's create the other style. Let's say we want to create something like this. I will just do stair 2, and this time we can just use this stair and create a reference geometry, let's say minus 40 mils. So that's the timber top, zoom selected, and then we want the vertical riser, so extrude vertical, and we give it a different material, call it mesh riser, change object, we'll create this as a block. Step 2, array linear 14, same steps, and this time we'll just extend this minus 30 and this side also 30 mils out, and we can see that there is some structure behind. We can just add the structural member here. Polyline. Offset, let's say 8 mils. Merge all faces, and we can just mirror it on the other side, or this has to be slightly inside, so minus 150 mils, and then we mirror it with the midpoint, and then we say okay. Now we'll just use the rendered view, and still we don't see that, so we'll just make the mesh to be slightly a different material. So click on this, import, okay, so we have got this there. Now we'll create something else. Let's create this one, which is a timber profile again. So what we can do is just draw that profile. Okay, so in case we don't want to use this as a reference, we would just stair 3, double click, just use this as a copy. 10 meters, and this time we'll just create the profile, so make sure it's shaded, and 250, or you can say 300 mils, and just click any point for now, and then press F10, or remove it. And then we say fillet corners, and let's say 20 mils. Okay, seems to be a bit more. Fillet 10 mils, fillet, and then we use the fillet, and we say 30 mils for the bottom, and we extrude this 1 meter, and then we block it. Block, step 3, array linear, and this time we need the reference, so we'll draw the line. So this one we say 250, and minus 150 array linear 14. The profile can be changed later on as well because it's a block. And then we have the relinks 3 per step. So select this, this, and move it 900 mils. Move it in minus 50. Or this time we can use a pipe. Pipe 20 mils. You just divide this segment into 3 parts, or actually we need 4 parts, 4 parts, and then cylinder double click on the block, add objects. Now, since we are not sure about the spacing, probably it will be a bit more. So let's say it should be more than what it is. So maybe 1.5 times more. So what we do is we just say OK for now. We can see that there is some discrepancy. So from this point, we can just check the distance. So this is length, this is 250. Now this has to be divided equally. For that we need to make sure that the railings are equal. So, divide into 3 parts and then we move this one and this one to this point. And then we say okay. Now this gives equal distance. Now if you want to maintain equal on the thread, like move it to the center, we can move it to the center. Perfect. So now we'll just make sure that this block, the extend is trimmed. So we'll select this and boolean difference, delete the top part and we say OK. Yes, I hope you like this video, and if you want further tutorials on anything, feel free to comment in this video so I can make new videos for you. And please don't forget to like, subscribe and hit the bell button so you can get more notifications about these videos coming next. I am going to create a separate series of videos on different projects. You can specify which project you want me to make and I'll make those videos for you guys. Hope you like this video and see you again in the next video.